Hey, Samson, what's up, man? Hey, man, y'all got any info for me on the Note 20? Oh, y'all mad? You still mad about that? Do not buy the S20 Ultra? I told you, I told them to buy the S20 Plus instead. I'm looking out for players' pockets, which is fair. And then I told them to wait for the Note 20, your best phone, probably your most expensive phone. Like, man, what you, man? Woo! What up? What up, YouTube? My name is CJ. This is CJ Knows Tech, where I know tech, so you don't have to. And today we're gonna talk about five things that I hate about my Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus. Now wait, before you click off the video, hold up, player. Let me tell you something. This is still the king. And with that being said, for those who don't know, I am technically an Apple user, but I absolutely adore and love the Galaxy Note phone every year. I'm gonna talk about five things that kind of irritate me, five things that I would love to see changed in the Note 20 or the Note 11, whatever we're getting. It's probably gonna be called the Note 20. And Note 20, who knows, Ultra, maybe Note 20 Fold. What up, Samsung? Hit me up. Yo, Samsung, what's up? Oh, you still mad about? So needless to say, besides my Apple products, I love Samsung products, period. All right, let's get into it. Let me not go too long, you know, I know. The number one thing that I hate about the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus is that the screen is too curved. And it's not in the sense that everyone else, you know, a lot of people complain about ghost touches. I don't have that issue. And to fix that issue, I use a Rhino Shield bumper case. It just goes around the edge. It definitely decreases the amount of ghost touches that a lot of people get. But it's not that. My issue is when I'm using this here S Pen and I wanna go for a smart select and I wanna go from edge to edge and then I have to ride up the side of that edge. Right when I get to that curve, oh, the pen, you know the slippery glass, this thing just go. Y'all gonna see in the video, I got some B-roll showing you guys, but the second that happens, I cannot get an edge-to-edge smart select capture, and that's super annoying, because I like the screen capture, I like to create my own GIFs, and I love using my S Pen, so the fact that that's being limited by the curvature of the screen, now it has been fixed on the S20 model, so I'm assuming for it to be fixed, or greatly improve on the Note models, because that's where we need it the most. We're using the S Pen on the screen, and when you get to the edge of the display, it's a wrap, player. You're falling off the waterfall, your pen is, you lose all control. So that's one of the number one. This is probably my biggest pet peeve on the Note 10 Plus. Now let me tell you, let me keep it real. It was hard to find five things that I find annoying on this Galaxy Note 10 Plus, because it's absolutely amazing. Is it perfect? No, that's why we still got FOMO. Let's get into number two. Now, if you watch my videos, it is no secret that I am not the biggest fan of the front-facing camera on these Galaxy devices. Samsung, you know what I mean? What up, player? Man, y'all gotta fix y'all front-facing camera for video. Let me put that there. For photos, it's not as much of an issue because lock-in shot and then you snap the photo. But when you're doing video, you're moving. You know what I mean? We use these videos to do IG stories, maybe vlogging, and I like to use my cameras on smartphones for B-roll, for like quick on the spot B-roll. I got another joint or a piece of tech in my hand. I just bam, 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 do it with the smartphone. Don't always have to carry this big camera with this monitor and so forth. So that's something that I appreciate in phones, but the front facing is the main one I have the issues with. The rear facing cameras are really good. Front facing camera, not so much when it comes to video. I'm gonna play this video for you guys so you guys can see exactly what I'm talking about. All right, y'all, this is a test of the front-facing camera, and I kind of just want to demonstrate, like, see, that's my thing, like, and I get it, it's probably on, like, auto exposure adjustments and things, but if you're, like, vlogging, and you're moving, and then it's, like, I go from, you know, dark to light, like, randomly, and it's not because of the lighting in front of me has changed, but, like, maybe just because it's hard for this thing to focus, like, if the sun's out and so forth, so that just gets into the dynamic range and so forth. I just think if they could put a little more effort and improve that, I would, like, greatly appreciate it. Ooh, oh, look at that photo. Oh, my. Hey, this lighting, I got to get a quick little selfie right here. I'll put the selfies up. See, that's what I'm talking about. Front-facing camera for photos. It's looking fly, baby. Ooh. But when we get to the video, actually, I'm about to take a video right now live. You know I just showed you the, but actually in this environment, okay, so I think the biggest issue with the front-facing camera is just dynamic range. When you have lighting in your background, say the sun's behind you and so forth, the camera struggles. Now, that's all cameras. I'm gonna keep it a buck. All front-facing cameras are not the best, but the Note 10 Pluses front-facing camera is not the best of all smartphones. I'll just put it there, and that way, that puts perspective for you. There's a phone out there that has a better front-facing camera, pretty much. And I don't want to get you guys all stirred up, but Apple. But the cameras are great, they look good, and they have the potential to perform up to the specs of what I'm speaking of. Let's get into another reason, and this has to do with the cameras as well. The third thing that I hate about my Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus is the live video. The live focus video? What is that? Oh man, player, hold up. Let me activate it right now. Live focus. All right, we are right now using live focus video. Now, it will tell you when it's ready. It has to be a face. It doesn't do objects and things like that. It has to be you, a person. But sometimes it'll be like, I'll show you the video of it, like saying, oh, it needs to find a face. Even while my face is like literally on the screen, and then it'll say ready, and it goes. All right, you guys, right now we're gonna test the live focus video, baby. Now, it's not the worst, it's not the best. I'm not sure what the bokeh is looking like behind me and how good it's cutting me out. Like, I'm looking at myself in this display. It looks fairly decent, but I remember when I first got it, when I first tested it, it wasn't the best. Now, this isn't the most challenging situation because my background isn't as busy as, say, if I were outside with leaves and things. But right now, I'm just doing this for test sake and just, you know, find a face. See, it has not found my face. Oh, there you go. Now it says it's ready. See, that's what I'm talking about, player. I don't think it's at that level to where it really emulates what you get with like a traditional mirrorless or a DSLR camera. But granted, it's a smartphone camera. What am I asking? All of these five reasons, I'm nitpicking. I have to nitpick to get this video. But these are things that I want to see improved on the next model of the Galaxy Note 20. Note 20 Ultra or Note 20 Fold, whatever we're getting. I want to see these things improved and just perform better. That's it. I think Samsung needs to go in the lab and like work at their cameras for video. Them and Google. Because Google got the photo thing down, but they don't have the camera thing down. Same thing with Samsung. They got to get the video down. I'm just keeping it a buck. Apple kind of got it. Apple actually does have it. That's something, a small nitpicky thing that can be fixed, hopefully. And I would love to just see it improve. Now, reason number four that I hate my Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus. It's gonna be, let me show y'all right here now. Let me, it's no secret. You've seen my videos before about it. Oh, it worked right there perfectly. It's not consistent. It's the in-glass fingerprint sensor. Now, there's times where I'm trying to hit this bad boy and it does not perform. You know what I'm saying? Let's see, bam. It's gotten better. Oh, man, this thing kind of hitting, it's kind of hitting a little better today. I'm gonna keep it a buck. But in the past, and even I'll show you the B-roll, there's some times where it does not register my fingerprint. It's not as accurate. I'm gonna give it a 70% of accuracy, which isn't the worst. It's not terrible, but I feel like it could be a little bit more accurate. You know, when you're used to a traditional, and this is not traditional, this is new tech, obviously, and we have to consider that in our heads. But the thing is, we as people, we're creatures of habit, and if we're used to something being like that, regardless of the technology and how it's implemented, we're used to that convenience. And it's just about working to improve that technology because it's new so that it does become as convenient as the actual physical fingerprint sensor. That's all. Just pushing Samsung to keep, you know, doing what they're doing. And I've heard that it's gotten better on the S20 Ultra models from reviewers who actually have those early units. You know, Samsung player could use the early, definitely for the Note. If y'all don't know, my squad get down for the Note. If y'all love the Galaxy Note devices, smash that like button right now. Smash that sub button. Let Samsung know that your boy right here is the captain of El Galaxy Note. Yeah, I hear that it's improved on the S20 Ultra models, and I'm looking forward to when I get my S20 model in hand. I'm not gonna tell you which one is coming. You'll see when it gets here. I'm gonna definitely test that and report back to you guys. So by the time, you guys got a lot of time to be developing right now, Samsung and getting it together for the Note 20 or Note 11, whatever you're gonna call it. Okay, the last thing that I dislike, or should I say that I hate about the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus, oh, I'm fed up. I don't want it anymore after this. I'm just playing. Number five, the biggest complaint I see amongst the community in tech and just in general is the update time window. Now, what does Samsung do? They look at what features are on the upcoming Android and some that aren't, and they give you that up front. Yo, bravo to Samsung for doing that and being forward thinking, so that way we don't feel it. So like a lot of things that came in the future, Android, Samsung already implemented, you know, like the multi-window, all kind of stuff like that. But even with Android 10 finally getting to the Note 10 Plus, there are some new gestures and so forth, and there are benefits to the newest and latest Android platform. So when you have, like me, I always own the Pixel. So when I see the updates come to the Pixel super fast, you know, and you wanna use those latest updates of Android and you wanna experience it, I'm gonna have to reach to my Pixel to experience it, which means that this gets benched so that I can experience the latest Android platform to report to you guys and to enjoy it and to just see what it's all about and what it has to offer. You know, I gotta bench my Galaxy Note 10 Plus and go grab the Pixel 4 XL and use that because the updates are super fast on there. Now, granted, that is a Google phone, and to Samsung's credit, I will give them credit. They were quicker this year, but I don't know if it's quick enough. So these are five nitpicking things that I'm just throwing out there, things that I just wanna see improve and things that I'm nudging Samsung to do better at and to get better at. And these are the things that would just make my experience, my user experience, as well as your user experience on the Galaxy Note 10 Plus just that much more fire. But still, the Note 10 Plus is definitely king, baby. It's still the top tier experience that you can have on a Samsung or any smartphone device out there. Man, this is probably one of the most beautiful smartphones on the market. Do you see this display? Do you see this beauty? This is amazing. Absolutely love it, man. Hold on, let's hit you with the bright side. Woo! Quad HD, best looking display. This is probably the best looking smartphone that's out right now, period. Like, I'm keeping it a buck. This thing looks amazing. Every time I pick it up and I experience this near bezel-less beauty, I'm just amazed and I'm in awe. And then when we hit you with the Aura Glow Player, do you see that? Aura Glow? Oh wait, let me get my fingers off. Did I put some fingerprints on here? Hold up, player. Oh, man, where my microfiber cloth? 1 second, man, we gotta, bam! Woo, Aura Glow Beauty, baby. Let me hit you in the face, bam! So, get your one, get your some. I'm not telling you don't get this phone, I'm just, yelling at Samsung and telling them what I want to be improved. So less of a curve, you know what I'm saying? Better in-glass fingerprint sensor technology, better cameras, especially the front-facing camera for video and stuff. There's other characteristics to Samsung cameras, which is a different video. And I guess I'll talk to it when I get my S20 and stuff, if it hasn't been improved, but we'll see. You guys, we shall see. My name is CJ, this is CJ Knows Tech, where I know tech, so you don't have to. Smash that like button, smash that sub button, watch another video, watch one of my video, or one of my dope tech creator friends, or any videos on the YouTube platform. Just don't go nowhere, player. Stay tuned. Where my remote? I lose my remote every time I sit down to record. Hello? Who this? What up, Samsung? Look, man, I'm not taking it down. I said what I had to say. Oh, I did make a mistake. About the 108 megapixel camera on the S20 Ultra. It is technically 108, but it's like many 9 megapixels in each. Man, come on, man. That's too much, man. Listen, it's not really technically, you know what I mean, a full-size 108 megapixel camera, so I was right. And there is artificial intelligence being used. I'm right. You know what I'm saying? I just wasn't all the way right. Yeah, okay, but the rest of the video, I got perfect valid points, right? Right. No, I won't stop. I won't stop. I won't stop. No, I won't stop. I won't stop.